Wow, this book is so good. It's about, I can't remember. How many times have you read something and then 5 seconds later you have to go back and reread that same page because you can't remember what you read? Here's the solution for that. Check this out. Hey guys, Ron White here. Now we've all been there. We've all read a page and then 2 seconds later we have to go back and reread that page because we have no idea what we just read. Here's the solution for that. And this process can be broken down into 6 easy steps. Let's start with step number 1. Don't try to memorize as you're reading, but instead read with a highlighter or a marker and underline or highlight the key words as you are reading, or take notes as you're reading, but don't try to memorize as you read. Number 2 is you need a technique or a tool called the Mind Palace, or it's called the Method of Loci. Essentially what it is you memorize a map of a room. Stand in the doorway of every room in your house and number 5 pieces of furniture in each room. The first room, you might, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It might be desk, bed, TV, picture, plant. Then go to the next room and number that room 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. The good things will be desks or chairs or computers or windows or showers or sinks. This is your mind palace, and this is actually going to hold the data that you are memorizing in the book. Which leads us to step number 3. Step number 3 is whatever you want to remember, you need to turn it into a picture. Let's say you're reading a book about Abraham Lincoln. The picture for Abraham Lincoln could be a penny, because Abraham Lincoln is on the penny. And maybe you want to remember he was born in Kentucky, so you're going to need a picture for Kentucky. Maybe you would use the Kentucky Derby. And maybe you want to remember he was the 16th president. You need to create a picture for 16, and you might use a car for that because you get your driver's license when you're 16 years old. So everything you have highlighted or everything you have underlined, you're going to need to create pictures for to remember those highlighted or underlined words. Pretty easy, right? All right, let's move on to step number 4. Step number 4 is you use the pieces of furniture in your room to store the data. The first point that you want to memorize is Abraham Lincoln was born in Kentucky. So you think of a penny, and a penny is racing around the Kentucky Derby. Now you take that picture and you put it on the first piece of furniture in your house. Maybe the first piece of furniture in your house is a table. So a penny racing around the Kentucky Derby. The second thing you want to remember is Abraham Lincoln was the 16th president. So you see a penny for Lincoln and the penny is driving a car for 16, and you see that on the second piece of furniture, which may be the refrigerator. You see a penny driving a car around the refrigerator. Every point that you have underlined, you turn into a picture and you would see on pieces of furniture around your house. 5 in a room. And that's how you remember points from a book. All right, guys, let's go on to step number 5. Step 5 is simply, if you want to remember 5 points from every chapter, you use one room to represent every chapter because you have 5 pieces of furniture in every room. If you want to remember 10 points from a chapter, easy enough. You just use 2 rooms to represent that chapter. And if you want to remember 15 points from a chapter, easy enough. You just use 3 rooms for that chapter. So those are the 5 steps that you need to memorize what you read. If you want to remember dates, like you're reading a history book, there is an optional 6th step. To remember dates, you need to create pictures for the date. For example, maybe you use a Cupid for Valentine's Day, for February. For March, you might use soldiers marching to remember the month of March. April showers to remember the month of April. So that's an optional 6th step, creating a pictures for the months to remember important dates if you're reading a history book. So in recap, number 1, don't memorize as you read, but instead highlight or underline as you read. Number 2, create a mind palace, locations in room where you're going to store the data. Number 3, turn whatever you want to recall into a picture. See it as an animated image. Number 4, store those pictures on the pieces of furniture around your house in your mind palace to remember the details of what you read. Number five, you segment the chapters. You put everything about one chapter in one room. And then finally, the optional sixth step, if you want to remember dates, you just need to create pictures for those dates. This is a simple method. It's called the Mind Palace. Sherlock Holmes used it in his books. So it's completely free. Click the link right here or click the link below, and I'll see you on the next page as you get this Sherlock Holmes Mind Palace training. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'm going to show you some bloopers here in a second. But before you do that, click the subscribe button right here. You're going to want to get plenty more of these memory training videos. Click it right here and subscribe. Wow, I am reading this great book here on the history of America. Did you know that, how many times have you read something? That's kind of jumpy there. All right.